Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to the third and last day of Wellness India 2018 Expo. Now we start with our first session on nutrition for a healthy living. Our moderator, Ms. Ishi Khosla, founder Whole Foods India, will be commencing the session. May I please request ma'am to briefly introduce our distinguished speakers on the dais. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. First of all, thank you for having us here. We are commencing the session on nutrition for healthy living. The topic of nutrition always interests everybody because we are seemingly far more aware of nutrition and food today than ever before, than our parents and our previous generations, but are still struggling with issues, not being able to be as fit or as good with our food habits, which is a real paradox, that we have much more information, but we seemingly feel like almost like failures very often, blaming ourselves that we can't be as good as we should. And there are reasons for this, and hence we are having this kind of an engagement. Simultaneously, while in nutrition education, information, knowledge has grown immensely in the last 50 years, we have also seen an increase in lifespan. Longevity has increased across the world. However, we are also witnessing a sort of increase in disease burden, right from undernutrition, malnutrition, to overnutrition, and almost new diseases which we've never heard of are springing up. And we have these challenges. And I think we have a wonderful opportunity today to have experts from very diverse fields with us, and we will have them shortly on the stage to share with you the picture with health and wellness and food. And I will request our panelists, first of all, Dr. Deepali Bhardwaj, who's the founder and director of Center of for Skin and Hair Clinics, to be on stage. Dr. Sarthak Bakshi, CEO International Fertility Center, is not with us right now, but I think will join us. Mr. Harish Chand, Regional Technical Specialist, Child Health and Nutrition, World Vision of India. Please, may we have you, sir? Dr. Sriram Damodaran, Chief Scientific Officer, Neuro Club. Dr. Shyama Nagarajan, Director, Whole Leaves Private Limited. Ms. Preeti Rao, founder of CEO, founder and CEO of Weljii. Before we start the discussions individually, I request each of our panelists to briefly introduce to the audience what they are doing. And so before we get on to a collective interaction, I've been in the profession for the last about 25 years, and I have seen a sea change in the way people are seeking information and people are reacting towards nutrition information. From a time when I had to motivate the audience to wake up and see where they are, how they are eating, how they are looking, their bellies, their blood works. I was in the Escorts Heart Institute in those days, and we used to have several public undertaking lectures, and you know, we found that people were really not interested except if they had had a bypass or they had some medical problems, diabetes, to address their food and nutrition. But today, I think it's completely changed, and I'm not exaggerating, that people are wanting to know more and to add more and more to their value to their food. Somewhere there is a feeling that we can do so much more. And it's very heartening to know that. And I'll share with you a personal journey also with when I started a health food company called Whole Foods in 2001. Most people just did not even know what health foods meant. And they said, what is this about? What is it different? What are you doing different than the others? What is organic food? Why is it so costly? Why? So, from there to now, it's been a huge change. And I have people coming to the store and asking, why isn't everything in your store organic? You know, so there is a lot of shift in people's attitudes and seeking information. And something which I'm going to share with you, a perspective of why we are not being able to utilize this information and knowledge. Almost on every packed food, there is calories, proteins, fats, right? How many of us really go through it? Hardly. Even if you go through it, are you able to put it to good use? No. So, I want you to know that I think we have tried to make nutrition science, make nutrition information available to the public without realizing that it is rather complex. It is a great tool for the experts, for the nutrition professionals to have. But if I try to make all of you nutritionists and educated in nutrition, I think I'm being overambitious. And I think this is the biggest drawback in our science and in the way we have looked at eating and dieting and healthy food. Food actually is not equal to nutrition. Food is not about nutrients alone. Food is about, now number one answer, food is about, be honest. Sorry? Energy, okay. I did get you. Happiness. Food is about happiness, and we have mental health experts who will first agree with me that however educated about nutrients I am, I will first decide whether I like it or no. It's a relationship which is completely, it cannot be challenged. There is no sincerer love than the love of food. This is Bernard Shaw. And I think we all will resonate with that. Khana acha hona chahiye, hame acha lagta hai khana. Uske baad, taste, of course, is a part of it, and pleasure, and then the nutrition kicks in. Very few people will just eat just because it's nutritious. How many of you agree with me? Is there anyone who doesn't agree with me? There you are. So let's not, it's a very personal thing, what I like to eat. So let's first address that. Khali calories and saturated fat and unsaturated fat and fiber and vitamin C, ye sab karke bahut gadbade ho gayi. Bahut lopsided ho gaya. Aur natija kya hua? एक तो हमारी फूड इंडस्ट्री ने उस पे खूब कब्जा किया. आई एम बीइंग वेरी ऑनेस्ट, फैट फ्री, सैचुरेटेड फैट फ्री, कोलेस्ट्रॉल फ्री, आजकल और भी चीज़ें हो गई, ग्लूटेन फ्री, ये डेयरी फ्री, हाँ हुआ ना, लो कैलोरी. फैट फ्री में क्या हुआ? शुगर बढ़ गई. इतनी सारी चीज़ें फ्री हो गई तो प्रिजर्वेटिव्स बढ़ गए, इतने सारे इंग्रेडिएंट्स बढ़ गए. पेस्टिसाइड लेडन फूड, जीएम फूड, microwave food, hydrogenated fat, sab pass ho gaye. Kyun? Kyunki calories, proteins, fats barabar the. Even fake food mein, even adulterated milk is very hard to test because the fats and the solids and everything comply. You getting me? So we have had certain issues by trying to educate the public on nutrients. We have had some setbacks, and I think we need to talk more in terms of food as food rather than simply nutrients. What do I mean by that? I mean we must talk about cereals. Jaise pehle baat hoti thi, anaj, dalein, phal, sabzi, nuts, seeds, meetha, doodh, paneer, dahi, meat, chicken, fish. Let's talk food. Hamari science mein, apne nutrition science mein, hum log recognize nahi karte the ki calorie, ek calorie, say 100 calories eaten in the morning versus 100 calories eaten in the evening are the same. हम लोग यही मानते थे कैलोरीज कैसे बदल सकती हैं सुबह और शाम, लेकिन बदलती हैं. जो आप सुबह खाते हो वो शाम को अलग तरीके से बिहेव करता है. व्हाट दोज कैलोरीज आर मेड अप ऑफ इज आल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट? सो माय पॉइंट हियर इज आई एम गोइंग टू बी वाइंडिंग अप बिकॉज वी हैव एक्सलेंट पैनलिस्ट वेटिंग. सो प्लीज स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट फूड एज फूड. लेट्स नॉट बिकम स्लेव्स ऑफ न्यू फैट डाइट्स. इंडस्ट्री ने भी फायदा उठाया, और क्योंकि हम लोग अपनी डाइट्स को मैनेज नहीं कर पाए तो क्या हुआ, बर्थ ऑफ फैट डाइट्स. कभी कीटो डाइट आजकल चल रही है, कभी जीएम डाइट है, कभी एटकिंस डाइट है, कभी इंटरमिटेंट फास्टिंग है. जब सब कुछ नहीं चला तो अब फास्टिंग पे आ गई, इंटरमिटेंट फास्टिंग आजकल चल रहा है, सुना है सबने. These are the new fad diets, and there are thousands and thousands of diets if you surf the net. Usme kya hua, kisi ne protein badhaya, kisi ne fat badhaya, kisi ne carb kam kiya, to wo hum nutrients se hi khelte rahe. Ek holistic approach nahi aayi, ek sustainable approach nahi aayi. So I really want after this forum that all of you think about what you are doing, where you are going. Let's understand food a little better. There is no shortcut. Understand how much we have to eat, when we have to eat, and a very, very important piece which we have neglected, all our traditional systems of healing. Traditional systems of healing include Ayurveda, naturopathy, and homeopathy. Everybody addresses the fact that all diseases begin in the gut. So how you digest food? ये तो हमने बात ही नहीं करते. It's a fact that today even modern science, our science of nutrition, is understanding the role of the gut in promoting diseases and preventing diseases. And that takes me to a huge area of what we say, one man's food and the other man's poison. सबके लिए सब कुछ लागू नहीं हो सकता. The whole area of food sensitivities. And let me tell you, thanks to modern food habits, lifestyles, the agricultural practices, the use of so many medicines and toxins, for no fault of ours, we have been completely victims of these things. Our guts have changed. The food sensitivities have gone up in the last 2 decades by a whooping 50%, according to the Center for Disease Prevention, US. 50% food sensitivities badh gayi hain. So kisko kya suit karta hai, kiski digestion kaisi hai, it has to be customized. And therefore, mass messaging may not be the approach. We need to understand what we are able to handle individually. Would you agree with me on that? There are general principles which we must know. Food must be understood, but the application of all this knowledge has to be customized. One more point I'll make before I leave is the area of nutritional deficiencies in a time when there is surplus. Malnutrition and obesity, malnutrition and undernutrition, malnutrition and starvation in poor socioeconomic areas is understood, but malnutrition in surplus is shocking, and it really disturbs me when individuals young and old over 100 kgs come with rock bottom iron levels, B12 levels, vitamin D levels, whatever we check is rock bottom. And that again takes me back to the question of the gut. If our gut is not healthy, we are not going to be able to absorb our food, no matter how much we eat. In a land of sunshine, like India, vitamin D is surplus. Our scientists, our professionals, our colleagues were refusing to accept that vitamin D could be deficient in our population. Today, almost everybody we check is deficient, whether exposed to the sun, whether a sportsman, or indoors, it's not helping. So again, it goes back to the gut. Iron levels, anemia prevention, we've had programs since the 1965s, free iron folate has been distributed. We had 70% of our women and children suffering from anemia, and despite all our efforts and surplus food, that figure hasn't changed. So it's time to reflect on our gut, go inwards, relook at food and the way we are eating. And very tempted to add, because we have health professionals from the mental health point of view, that even modern science is now accepting the fact that the gut has a huge role to play in mental health. Almost 80% or more of the neurotransmitters which are connected with happiness and appetite control and many, many others are secreted in the gut. So if our gut is unhealthy, we are going to be prone to having mental health issues. And I'm not surprised, depression has become one of the most disabling diseases in the world, and WHO declared last year as the year for addressing depression and mental health conditions. So these are just pointers and few thoughts, food for thought for all of you. We'll have more discussions as we go on. And something I'll just sign off on. When the food is wrong, medicine will not work. And when the food is right, medicine is not needed. Thank you so much. We'll continue the session. So now we'll have Dr. Deepali Bhardwaj share her insights into dermatology.
Yes, thanks. And I think I must say that I've shared the dyes before with Ishi, and we've grown up, as doctors, we have always looked up, because she was right there when nobody else was doing this. But she's phenomenally, with years, and this field has grown, I think, scientifically, and with so much of research going regularly. So we really have a great person to moderate the session today. All I would say is, like, what she said is so right. It actually takes a lot of guts. There has been time, I think, hum sabke zindagi mein wo samay aata hai, gol gappe dekhe khalo, tikki bhi khalo, ghar jaake khana bhi khalo, uske upar bhi kuch khalo. I think what are we pressuring our guts? Just imagine. So a lot of us North Indians, we've all done that. And mere ghar mein aloo paratha milta tha breakfast mein when I was growing up. So yeah. So besides that, see, as a dermatologist, of course, I meet about at least 20 people if I meet every day. They all have the same thing. And even men. Ki mujhe shining skin chahiye, chehre pe dullness hai, body dull lag rahi hai, mera boyfriend mujhe nahi dekhta, mera fiance mujhe mein interested nahi hai, mera extramarital boyfriend khush nahi hai. It's so common. You know, we all women have this thing ki shine nahi hai. And I get tired that see, I'm not a beauty parlor, I'm not a beautician. Main har ek ko yehi kehti hu, and I'm a very scientific oriented doctor. So what you do is what you eat. Like what you said is what you eat is with your guts and mind. Strongly, that body image, your mental image about yourself, everything depends on what is going inside. What is going inside is what you're eating, what your thoughts are, what you believe about yourself. I strongly believe that as a strong affirmation. So beauty is completely inside out. Agar aap young age mein hi, haan, jo young bachche hain, agar wo abhi seekh lein ki hum log, hamari zindagi wohi hai jo hum andar dal rahe hain. So aap positive thoughts, healthy cheeze khaye jo aap aage panel discussion se food ke bare mein zyada baat karenge. So I'm not going to get into it, but beauty cannot be just outside. Always remember that, because skin is actually deeper than what we know. So you know, this is just a picture to tell you that skin is deep. That's my favorite star. So I mean, he's animating, of course, and he's a lovely actor, but you know, there's a lot of works which go by skin specialists to create such kind of faces that with age there is no wrinkles. Ab jaise inke chehre pe jo pigmentation hai, agar ye tala hua khayenge to of course ye badhta rahega inke dane, and jo gadde hain, jo dull skin hai, ye sab badhta rahega if she's not eating healthy. But if you eat, what I say, where Ishi can of course add to me, but what I have, you know, been practicing myself is what I tell everybody, ki rozana do alag rang ke phal khaye, so that it completes your antioxidants. So red, yellow, green, purple. Ye char rang hain jo hume roz khane hain. So if you can have that in baked or grilled forms, if you can have some sort of, say, antioxidant as supplement, it's definitely going to help you in giving your skin glow. That is the easiest formula. Having some natural seeds will help in, you know, keeping your skin more moisturized, which from the young age you need to keep. ये नहीं है कि मैं अभी young हूँ तो मुझे क्या ज़रूरत है, मगर शुरू से जो हमारे skin के जो basic cells के बीच में acid है, वो from the age of 5 या 7 कम होना शुरू हो जाता है. So अगर आप शुरू से ही flax seeds and ऐसे essential fatty acids को body में एक level बना के रखें, maybe शुरू में at your in your teenage you're just giving 1/2 teaspoon. With age, 1 full teaspoon of flaxseed. It's going to complete your acid levels, the requirement of EFAs and everything in the body, because you can't really trust what we are eating today. I mean, we can't even trust the milk maybe that we buy and have. So these are certain things which we do as a dermatologist. Everything cannot be just what you eat also. You will have to visit a dermatologist for maybe wrinkles and the damage that has happened. Jo scars pad gaye hain ya kuch nishan aapke chehre pe aa gaye hain. तो वो सिर्फ खाने से या योगा से नहीं ठीक होंगे. सो दैट इज़ वाई इट्स अ होलिस्टिक अप्रोच. देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट लाइक अ कॉकटेल विच गोज, एंड मेन कॉकटेल इज वॉट यू आर डूइंग एट होम योर सेल्फ. सो अगर आज हमारे साथ रूम में आप 20 लोग होंगे, सो आई थिंक 20 में से अगर 5 लोग भी अपनी लाइफ स्टाइल में कुछ चेंज आज हमारे इस पैनल से कर पाए, आई थिंक इट्स गोइंग टू हेल्प मैसिवली. So यू कैन सी दीज आर सर्टन रिजल्ट विच आई हैव क्रिएटेड, वेयर वी रिमूव द डबल चेन ऑफ समबडी हु इज ईटन अ लॉट. And so this is some scars and anti-aging which we have done for this patient. Hair transplantation is something which we do. But strongly, I tell everybody, you are just what you eat. So for a very good glowing skin, it has to be a holistic approach, because beauty is not this, as you see on this slide, which is not the Indian beauty. So maybe all these ladies are smiling. And pigmentation, yes, for this, I make simple gharelu nuska jo sabko kehti hu, it's in your kitchen. आप चेहरे पे नींबू जूस और टमाटर जूस और सैंडलवुड पाउडर रोज अपने चेहरे पे लगाएं और 15-20 मिनट बाद धो लें. फॉर एनी एज, एनी बडी फॉर डल स्किन कैन डू दिस, और हर एक के घर में ये होता है. इट्स अ वेरी वेरी इजी टू डू नुस्खा. सो वी डू लॉट ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट्स, वी डू सेवरल लेजर्स, एंड आई एम बेस्ड इन डिफेंस कॉलोनी. वेल यू कैन सी इन लेडी की जो उंगलियां हैं, मैंने ये तस्वीर इसलिए डाली है, हालांकि पुरानी हो गई है मेरी इस प्रेजेंटेशन में, मगर दिस लेडी केम टू मी आफ्टर डूइंग सेवरल ब्लीचेस एट सेवरल ब्यूटी पार्लर्स एंड विजिटेड मेनी डॉक्टर्स. सो ऑल व्हाट शी हैड वाज B12 डेफिशिएंसी एज सून एज आई सॉ, बिकॉज आई वर्कड इन प्रैक्टिस एट सफदरजंग हॉस्पिटल, सो हम वहाँ पे बहुत देखते थे ये. सो दिस इज जस्ट B12 कमी. सो ईटिंग जस्ट एप्पल अ डे विल एक्चुअली कीप हर अवे फ्रॉम इवन द ब्यूटी पार्लर, नॉट जस्ट अ डॉक्टर. So it's just what you eat. So if you actually eat a lot of B12, your pigmentation on the, you know, the ends of the body will definitely get better. So ये बहुत strong बात है याद रखनी, क्योंकि हम लोग बहुत सोचते हैं ऊपर से makeup लगा लो, ladies में ये होता है, men feel complex, वो कहीं भी नहीं जाते पूछने के लिए. So you must know that strongly जो आप खा रहे हैं उसी से आपकी beauty and सुंदरता बनेगी.
So Deepali, I just want to ask you, as a practitioner, you've been in practice for
7 years now.
7 years. So what are the kind of things that you are seeing more in your practice with respect to
with respect to, I see a lot of poor body image, especially in the youngsters, which I feel very sad about. So I have recently started a counselor at my clinic.
Okay.
And I feel that young girls should not lose confidence. Men in their 30s and 40s certainly is increasing. And interestingly, men ko sirf apne baalon se farak padta hai. Skin unki kitni bhi kharab ho, unko agar baal upar se sar se kam ho rahe hote hain, to unko lagta hai ki unki zindagi kharab ho gayi hai.
To aisa kyun ke pehle bhi aadmi the aur ab baalon mein kyun ab problem aa rahi? Are you seeing more
yes.
baldness
Definitely.
And alopecia in
You hit the nail, Ishi, you can add to this, but a lot of men are doing protein diets. They are taking protein supplements, which leads to increased testosterone level in their bodies.
That is such an important point. Yes. That is such an important yes. point. And everybody who enters the gym, the first thing that is given to them is a
protein supplement.
Yes.
And those protein bars. I think these extra things that you would yes. definitely say yes. they are not so good for the body because they have preservatives. Why don't you go on real protein diets and meet people like Ishi and more people on the diets who can guide you on what to eat? Because
and yeah, even young children are being given protein powders.
Protein bars, yes.
And absolutely unwarranted. Or they are given some 12 egg whites and
yeah. Yes, and that's going to, I think, even increase the bad cholesterol at a young age. So
yes.
There are a lot of changes that can be done.
So and hair, and even in women there is a lot of alopecia, I think. A
lot of women are having hair fall. That's because of the keratin. Ki beauty parlor se jaake keratin kara liya. And the best thing is when they come to me and they've lost so much hair, they say ki hamari beautician ne kaha tha ye hair spa kara lo. So they've done several hair spas in the belief and spent 50,000 and come and balsam.
So what is a hair spa? Can you tell us?
I honestly am not very well aware, but hair spa mein 3-4 steps hote hain and it is done at every beauty parlor. And interestingly, at my clinic, there is no stem cells for hair as yet. Let me tell you, in India, we do not have real stem cells. We have nearest to stem cells called PRP, jo doctor clinics pe hota hai. But in India, small beauty parlors have stem cell hair pack and hair spas. So I have no idea what it's made of. But
so the important thing that you're saying is don't leave your skin and hair on small, you know, untested remedies
yes.
in parlors, and be very careful about what you apply
right. yes.
and eat. So any thing that you'd like to part with the audience?
I think please remember beauty is inside out. So जो आप डैमेज अपने ऊपर कर चुके हैं वो अब आप उसको रिमूव भी कर सकते हैं, कम कर सकते हैं और बढ़ने ना दें अपनी बॉडी पे. उसके लिए अपनी डाइट को, अपनी मेंटल थॉट्स को और स्ट्रेस लेवल्स को कम करें. एंड आई थिंक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एंटी एजिंग फूड आगे. सो आई जस्ट क्विकली फिनिश माई प्रेजेंटेशन. पहले के लोग ज़्यादा सुंदर लगते थे क्योंकि उनकी डाइट अच्छी थी, मेरा ये मानना है. सो दे वुडंट अवॉइड द घी एंड एवरीथिंग विच इज नीडेड.
दैट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट यू आर मेकिंग.
सो यस सो वी आर गोइंग टू एलैबोरेट फर्दर. ऑल द बेस्ट. Thank you,
Deepali. Thank you so much. So I think you are leaving.
Yeah, Dr. Bhardwaj has some urgent work. I think she'll have to take a leave. So I would just request Ms. Khosla to felicitate her with a token of appreciation on behalf of EI Group. Can we have a big round of applause? Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your valuable inputs.
So now we have Mr. Harish Chand with us. He will be talking to us about child health and nutrition. Yeah. So food and fitness. So please do introduce yourself briefly to the audience, and then we'll take it from there.
Hello, good morning all of you. My name is Harish Chand and I work for World Vision India, which is an international organization. And we basically work for the community nutrition, especially for the children who are stunting, who are wasting and who are underweight. So more of our work is into the villages, and we work more than 17 states in the country and 60 districts. So we work for health and nutrition. So that is, and I've been working with World Vision, especially in the health sector, for the past 20 years, and but more of in the community health and nutrition. So thank you for giving me this opportunity. Okay. So So my topic that was given to me, the fit and food connection. I think ये सुबह मैडम ने जो बात करा बहुत ही relevant है कि food का और physical health का एक बहुत ही एक connection है अपने आप में. और ये हम लोग सब जानते हैं, जो भी हम लोग खाना खाते हैं, जितना हम लोग खाना खाते हैं और जितना नहीं खाते हैं, उसका अंतर हमारे शरीर में हमको दिखता है. So there is a strong correlation between food and physical health. There is a very famous phrase, healthy mind. Healthy mind lives in the healthy body. तो अगर हमारा स्वस्थ शरीर है, तो हमारे स्वस्थ शरीर में स्वस्थ मन रहेगा. लेकिन अगर हमारा स्वस्थ शरीर है, स्वस्थ मन है, तो हम अपना जो लाइफ है, जो डे टू डे लाइफ है, उसको एंजॉय कर सकते हैं. बट अगर इसका उल्टा है, सपोज इट इज़ जस्ट अपोजिट ऑफ दैट, इफ़ आर बॉडी इज़ नॉट फिट, इफ़ आर हेल्थ इज़ नॉट फिट, देन आर माइंड विल ऑल्सो नॉट बी फिट, विल हैव ऑल साइकोलॉजिकल एंड मेंटल प्रॉब्लम. हो सकता है इरिटेशन हो गया, प्रॉब्लम हो गया, चिड़चिड़ापन हो गया, गुस्सा हो गया, ये सारी की सारी चीज़ें जो है हमारे, जब हमारा सपोज एक आदमी बीमार है और उसको कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, तो उसका जो असर है उसके दिमाग में भी पड़ता है, ये हम लोग जानते हैं. सो देर इज़ अ कनेक्शन बिटवीन फिजियोलॉजिकल हेल्थ एंड मेंटल एंड साइकोलॉजिकल हेल्थ. दूसरा ये भी है कि जो जो हमारा फिजिकल फिटनेस में जो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन है सबसे ज़्यादा, वो हमारे खान पीने का है, खाने पीने का, और दूसरा हमारे लाइफ स्टाइल का है. अगर सो इफ वी आर नॉट ईटिंग द प्रॉपर डाइट, इफ़ यू आर ईटिंग डाइट विच हैज़ हाई कैलोरी, और ऐसा कि जो हमारे रिक्वायरमेंट से ज़्यादा है, और दूसरा हमारा डे टू डे का लाइफ स्टाइल ठीक नहीं है, तो दैट ऑल्सो लीड टू द बॉडी फिजिकल हेल्थ ऑफ द पर्सन. सो मैं आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू टेल द पीपल, दोज हु आर यू नो कॉशियस अबाउट देयर हेल्थ, कि मैं बहुत कमज़ोर हो गया हूँ, मैं बहुत मोटा हो गया हूँ, मेरे से कुछ नहीं हो सकता, मैं इतना उम्र का हो गया हूँ, आई कॉन्ट डू एनी थिंग नाउ, लेट मी टेल यू एंड लेट मी अश्योर यू, इट इज़ नॉट टू लेट फॉर यू टू बिगिन योर यू नो फिटनेस ऑफ योर लाइफ. बहुत जल्दी हम इसको कर सकते हैं. सो वन फंडा यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड दैट इफ़ योर हेल्थ इज़ फिट, यू विल हैव ऑल्सो मेंटल टफनेस, यू कैन फेस एनी चैलेंज इन द लाइफ. ओके, नाउ व्हेन वी सी द करंट सिनेरियो ऑफ आवर कंट्री, दिस इज़ द NFHS 4 डेटा. हम भारत और इंडिया, हम ऐसे एक देश में रह रहे हैं जहाँ पर कि दो अलग अलग किस्म के लोग आप देखेंगे, जो है सोशो इकोनॉमिक इकोनॉमिकली वो पुअर हैं, बट एक साइड आप देखेंगे कि उन वो लोग जिनके पास पैसा है, सब कुछ है. सो जब आप इसमें देखेंगे, इस जो इस डेटा के बेस पे आप देखेंगे कि कुछ महिलाएं हैं, करीबन 22% वुमेन एंड 20% मेन आर अंडर वेट, दे आर माल नरिस्ट, गरीबी के कारण है या उनको खाना पीना नहीं मिल पा रहा है, सो उनका जो फिजिकल हेल्थ है दैट इज़ पुअर. बट द सेम टाइम आप दूसरी तरफ अपने राइट हैंड साइड देखेंगे कि जो ऐसी पॉपुलेशन भी है जिनका पैसा अच्छा है, जो खाना पीना अच्छा खा सकते हैं या कई चीज़ें हैं, उनके कारण जो है उनका जो माल न्यूट्रिशन ओबेसिटी है या ओवरवेट है, जितना एक वेट होना चाहिए एक नॉर्मल आदमी का, उससे वो 10% या 20% या उससे भी ज़्यादा जो है उनका वेट हो गया. सो व्हाट हैपेंस, जब इस तरह से वजन और सारी चीज़ें बढ़ती हैं, तो बहुत से जो डिजीज़ हैं, ओबेसिटी है, और ओबेसिटी के कारण जो बहुत से प्रॉब्लम हो गया. हम देखते हैं कि ये दोनों सेक्शन में, ख़ास तौर से जो जिस ऑडियंस को आज हम बात कर रहे हैं, मुझे लगता है हम एक अच्छे आई विल फोकस मोर इन टू द राइट साइड कोहर्ट ऑफ द पीपल एंड मे बी यहाँ पे हम लोग हैं उनमें से. सो जो हमारा खाने पीने का तरीका है, दैट इज़ टेकिंग अस टू द यू नो साइड ऑफ ओबेसिटी की तरफ लेकर के जा रहा है. और जब हम ओबेसिटी की बात करते हैं, सो हाउ टू हैंडल दैट, और ओबेसिटी के कारण वी नो सो देर आर सो मेनी इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू ओबेसिटी. ओके, वो हमारा हमारा डायबिटिक बढ़ा देता है, हमारा बोन्स में प्रॉब्लम कर देता है, हमारा जो मेटाबॉलिज्म सिस्टम है, जो पाचन क्रिया है, और जो अंदर से जो न्यूट्रॉन को बॉडी में लेके जाता है, अलग अलग सेल्स तक लेके जाता है, उस सारे सिस्टम को जो है डिस्टर्ब कर देता है. एंड सो बेसिकली द ओबेसिटी और ओवरवेट इज ए इमर्जिंग. सो अगर मैं आप पिछली स्लाइड देखेंगे, दोनों अभी एक ही साल NFHS-4 का ही डेटा है, अगले 5-10 साल के बाद आप डेटा देखेंगे, इसमें बहुत यू विल सी द इंक्रीज. सो हार्ट अटैक और दूसरी हार्ट अटैक हो गया, डायबिटीज़ हो गया, देन यू विल सी मोर पीपल डाइंग ऑफ हार्ट अटैक एंड डायबिटीज़ एंड अदर थिंग. सो इट इज़ ए अलार्मिंग सिचुएशन फॉर इंडिया टू एड्रेस बोथ द इश्यू, अंडरवेट एंड ऑल्सो द ओबेसिटी. ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज़ द मंत्रा, हाउ कैन वी, कैसे हम लोग जो है इस ओबेसिटी को, हम मैं खास तौर से ओबेसिटी के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में या ओवरवेट के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में ही बात कर रहा हूँ, हम कैसे इसको ठीक कर सकते हैं. पहला कि हमारा जो डाइट है, जैसे कि दीप्ति मैडम ने भी अभी हमसे, दीपाली मैडम ने अभी बात कर रहे थे कि जो हमारे खाने पीने का तरीका है वो यू नो जो हमारा बॉडी है ईश्वर ने ऐसे बनाया, इट इज़ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स बट इट फंक्शन इन वेरी सिस्टमैटिक मैनर. अगर आप देखेंगे हमारे जितने भी बॉडी में जो माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट हैं, जो भी हमें चाहिए बॉडी को फंक्शन करने के लिए, अगर एक की कमी होती है तो उसके कारण दूसरा जो माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट है उसका अब्जॉर्प्शन भी बॉडी में नहीं हो पाता है. सो आवर बॉडी सच ए डिज़ाइन इन सच ए वे बाय गॉड दैट इट इज़ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स बट स्टिल इट वर्क्स सो फाइन. तो हम अगर उसको डिसऑर्डर कर देते हैं बिकॉज ऑफ आवर लाइफ स्टाइल, बिकॉज ऑफ आवर फूड इनटेक, देन वी फेस द चैलेंज इन आवर लाइफ. सो बैलेंस डाइट में वट वी सजेस्ट, आई थिंक एवरीबडी नो, ये ऑडियंस यहाँ पे बैठी है, कि हमको जो फूड लेना है ये मेजर 3 फूड ग्रुप्स है. वी हैव टू इंश्योर दैट वी ईट फ्रॉम द 3 फूड ग्रुप्स एंड दीज आर बेसिकली एनर्जी गिविंग फूड. हमारे को जितनी कैलोरी चाहिए हमारे डे टू डे के लिए उतनी कैलोरी हमें इन फूड से मिलेगा. जितना प्रोटीन चाहिए बॉडी बिल्डिंग फूड से उतना हमें चाहिए, और जितना फूड हमको जो है हमारे इम्यूनिटी बढ़ाता है, हमारे न्यूट्रिएंट को बॉडी में लेकर के जाता है, अलग अलग सेल्स में अलग अलग काम करता है. सो वी नीड ऑल दीज फूड्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट फूड ग्रुप्स नाउ. एंड सो माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट जो हमको चाहिए इट्स आर वेरी आर रिक्वायर्ड टू मेंटेन एंड रेगुलेट आवर बॉडी. हमारे जो कॉम्प्लेक्स सिस्टम है बॉडी को, उसको मेंटेन करने के लिए हमको माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट चाहिए. एंड सो व्हाट वी सी, देयर इज सो मच डिफिशियंसी इन आवर डाइट. हम लोग बाजार का जाके खा लेंगे, सारी चीज़ों को खा लेंगे, लेकिन घर में बना हुआ क्यों. अभी मैडम जो बोल रही थी कि पुराने लोग जो है अभी भी स्वस्थ दिखते हैं, उनके घर में नेचुरल खाना बनता था. आप बाहर जाओगे आपको रिच इन कैलोरी मिलेगा, फेक कैलोरी मिलेगा, लेकिन दैट इज़ यू नो इल फॉर योर हेल्थ, आपकी हेल्थ के लिए सही नहीं है. सो वी हैव टू इंश्योर जब हम, और ये दिस इज़ गुड फॉर आर यंगर जनरेशन दैट वी प्लीज़ कम बैक टू आर नेचुरल होम. Eat your home cooked food. I'm very passionate about because I travel by metro. I see so many young boys and girls around the cafes. I'm not this thing, but please go back to the principle. Go back to your basics. Have food from your home food and make sure that you eat from all 3 groups. And ज़्यादातर part आपका you know whole food and vegetables. Now. That is one part. So there is a deficiency of nutrient in our body, in our diet. Secondly, we see that हमारा काम करने का तरीका भी अलग है. Some people, most of the people who are sitting here, they are the sedentary worker. But what happens? We eat more of calorie and we don't burn those calories. So हम जितना input करते हैं हम उतना output नहीं करते हैं, burn नहीं करते हैं. So वो gradually वो that you know calories it turns into fat and then we becomes obese. So that is a calorie requirement. And then we see ye jaise jaise hamari umar badhti hai the requirement of calorie also decreases. Jo metabolism hai hamara kaam karne ka jo activity hai wo kam ho jata hai. To 40 ke baad jo hamara umar ke anusar jo metabolism system bhi hai thoda lower ho jata hai, uske baad hamari activity bhi kam ho jati hai, isliye requirement bhi kam ho jati hai. Lekin you will see people eat more than more food than usual. So we have to see that
कि हम उसको जो खाना खाएं जितना रिक्वायरमेंट हमको चाहिए बैलेंस डाइट हमको चाहिए उससे हमें खाना है. सो व्हाट हैपेंस, सो जो मैं बता रहा हूँ, सो हाई एनर्जी डेंस फूड जो इनटेक हम लेते हैं जो ओबेस को बेसिकली बढ़ावा देता है, इट लीड्स टू हाइपरटेंशन, इट लीड्स टू मेटाबॉलिज्म सिंड्रोम, इट लीड्स टू क्रोनरी हार्ट डिजीजेज एंड टाइप टू डिजीजेज. एंड ऑल्सो जब उम्र बढ़ जाती है, थोड़ा मोटापा बढ़ जाता है, तो उसके वजह से आपकी जो बोन्स है उनकी डेंसिटी कम हो जाती है, ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस का प्रॉब्लम हो जाता है. यू नो सो ओवर वेट करने से बहुत ही जो आपके शरीर के लिए जो प्रॉब्लम्स हैं वो जो है जो बढ़ना शुरू हो जाता है. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू रियलाइज टुडे इज दैट वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट आवर फूड हैबिट्स. नाउ सेकेंड मंत्रा इज फिजिकल एक्सरसाइज. इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वी हैव टू डिसिप्लिन आवर लाइफ, वी हैव टू गेट अप ऑन टाइम, वी हैव टू स्पेंड एटलीस्ट 30 मिनट्स और 45 मिनट्स फॉर डेली एक्सरसाइज. जो भी आपने सो व्हाट इट हेल्प्स डेली एक्सरसाइज हेल्प्स इन लाइक यू नो बर्निंग द एक्सेस कैलोरी, जो आपकी एक्सेस कैलोरी है उसको हटा देता है ताकि आप फैट डिपॉजिट ना हो, आपका जो हार्ट अटैक का यू नो रिस्क है उसको रिड्यूस कर लेता है, कोलेस्ट्रॉल लेवल का जो है इसमें थोड़ा रिडक्शन हो जाता है, कई चीज़ें इसमें हैं. और आपका जब आप चलते हो तो आपके जब आप वॉक करते हो तो आपके बोन्स जो है स्ट्रांग हो जाता है, देन योर मेमोरी ऑल्सो गेट्स रिन्यूड, देन योर डाइजेशन ऑल्सो गेट्स यू नो प्रॉपर, यू नो योर मेटाबॉलिज्म इम्प्रूव. सो दीज आर एंड व्हाट वी सी दीज टू थिंग्स आर इफ यू कीप इन आवर माइंड दैट वी टेक डाइट फ्रॉम ऑल टू थ्री फूड ग्रुप्स इन प्रॉपर प्रोपोर्शन एंड डू द फिजिकल एक्सरसाइज, आई थिंक वी कैन रिड्यूस दैट बार, द राइट साइड बार जो हमने बात करी थी उसको हम लोग कम कर सकते हैं. सो सो वी आर नॉट इन टू, आई एम फ्रॉम वर्ल्ड विजन, सो वी आर नॉट इन टू NCD विच इज़ नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेज बिकॉज ऑफ ओबेसिटी एंड ऑल, वी आर मोर इन टू द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड जहाँ पे अंडर न्यूट्रिशन की हम बात कर रहे हैं. सो वी ऑल्सो बिलीव कि जो बच्चे कम वजन के पैदा होते हैं, चाहे वो बड़े घरों में हों छोटे घरों में हैं, जिनका वजन ढाई किलो से कम होता है, वो बच्चे उनको लो बर्थ वेट हम बोलते हैं, वो फ्यूचर में जा करके उनको भी ओबेसिटी या दूसरे प्रॉब्लम उनके जीवन में फोकस होते हैं. एंड सो वर्ल्ड विजन की तरफ से वी फोकस मोर ऑन हेल्दी बर्थ आउटकम सो दैट हेल्दी चिल्ड्रन आर बॉर्न एंड देर एंड देन वी ऑल्सो इम्फोसाइज द इन ए बैलेंस डाइट एंड इनटेक ऑफ फूड थ्रू आउट देयर लाइफ एंड ऑल्सो वी वर्क ऑन द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ लो बर्थ वेट. सो ओवरऑल जस्ट दो मंत्रा, प्लीज स्टिक टू योर डाइट एंड ऑल्सो डू द एक्सरसाइज, यू विल इंजॉय गुड हेल्थ, यू विल इंजॉय हैप्पीनेस एंड नथिंग इज बेटर देन हैप्पीनेस इन लाइफ.
थैंक यू सो मच मिस्टर हरीशन. जस्ट बिफोर वी मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्पीकर, यू मेंशन समथिंग अबाउट लो बर्थ वेट.
यस,
कैन यू जस्ट टेल द ऑडियंस एक्चुअली व्हाट इज द रिस्क इन हैविंग आइदर अ लो बर्थ वेट और मे बी द अदर साइड excess weight, both are linked to obesity and diabetes later.
Yeah, so low birth
point.
Yeah, thank you so much. So low birth weight, when we say low birth weight, any child who is born with less than 2.5 kg, we consider it a low birth weight baby, and that baby has high chance of mortality, first thing, because baby doesn't have the energy to suck the mother's milk and to collaborate or to cope up with the external environment around him. So one thing that there is a high chance that child may die, and secondly because child has child's requirement is less at that time for mother's milk or sugar and any other thing, but if we feed extra milk any other thing to the child, then child develop the diabetic after certain age. सो उसमें क्या होता है कि वो बच्चे के कारण जो है धीरे धीरे जब वो बढ़ता है उसकी रिक्वायरमेंट कैलोरी की हो प्रोटीन की हो या दूसरी रिक्वायरमेंट हो थोड़ी कम होती है, लेकिन जैसे जैसे वो उम्र में बढ़ेगा और परिवार के लोग उसको अधिक अधिक खिलाते हैं तो ये बच्चे बाद में जा करके क्योंकि जन्म किसके समय से लेकर के साल भर तक उनको हमने ज़्यादा क्योंकि हमें मालूम नहीं है माँ के दूध में तो जितना चाहिए उतना ही मिलता है उसको एनर्जी, लेकिन हम बाहर से उसको खिलाने के बाद जो एक छः महीने के अंदर में या साल भर के अंदर जो भी खिलाते हैं उससे जो है वो फ्यूचर में उसको ओबेसिटी हो जाता है और फिर उसके वो बच्चे भी जो है obese होने के कारण जो है फिर उनको वो heart attack और दूसरे issues में उनका.
So do you agree with the thrifty gene hypothesis?
No, there is a research also that it correlates.
So low if birth you weight. Have a low birth weight, then your genes hoard more fat.
Yes.
And then later on that becomes a tendency to make more fat in adult life.
Yeah.
Yeah, and both even high birth weight has similar consequences
yeah.
towards diseases later in life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
So now we would be talking about mental health. Dr. Sriram Damodaran, we're waiting to hear you. Yeah, okay.
Hi, my name is Sriram. I'm the director of DNM Labs in the United States. I have a neuroscience lab there, but I'm also the chief scientific officer of a company called Neuro Club. And my talk is specifically about the brain and how we understand it in the context of nutrition. Like all the speakers that we've heard from today, a lot of the context we understand is, you know, we've always heard if you eat food, healthy food at home every day, you should be fine. There is no problem. We don't need anything else. And of course, there is truth to that. But one aspect about nutrition is as the times change, our requirement for nutrition changes as well. Let's say we were in a time where things were very slow moving. You didn't have deadlines. You didn't have multinational companies who you worked for. The requirements of the brain were very different. Therefore, nutritional requirements for our body were also very different. Now we live in a time, as we all know, our body requirements are very different. If we are not able to deal with the stress in school, for students, for example, if we can't do well in our studies, the number of suicides that happen in India, it's unbelievable for students. It's reaching levels which are higher than any other place. Why? Because that is the requirement. We don't have a choice. We don't have any backup plan. If we don't get 90%, it's done. There's no other choice. Same with work. If I don't work till 9 p.m., 10 p.m. every day, I'm going to get fired. So now nutrition has a very different look. It has to do with giving us the things that allow our brain to function in the capacity that we need it to function in. Now, because of what we are used to with respect to food, we got those recipes from our grandmother, from our mother, father. They didn't necessarily think about what is required to increase our memory sustenance or what is required for us to concentrate for 4 to 5 hours at hand. No way, because the requirement that was there in different societal situations was very different from what we have now. Now, what are we doing to match that? What are we doing to match the new requirements that we have today? And that is what my research really had to do with. What it had to do with is, what are the mechanisms in our brain that are linked to many of these functions that are relevant for today? And is it possible to actually affect it? Because even if we eat healthy food, is that going to increase the chances that your memory is to the capacity is required to mug up all the histories of all the different countries in the world? I don't think so. We need to give an effort to have the nutrients that allow us to do that. So one of the things that I do in my lab is we have this electroencephalogram, EEG. So what we do is we have people and we measure the different brain waves that come out based on situations that they're in. So I don't know if you've heard of this, but there are certain things called alpha waves or beta waves or gamma waves based on the mental state that you're in. Now, those mental state that we are in, nowadays almost everyone, when we are working, for example now, everyone in this room, if I was to put an EEG on each one of our heads, we'll all be in beta wave frequency because we have to be very sensitive to the input that we are receiving. But say that there was a monk who was meditating right now, his frequency would be alpha wave. Now, my whole desire of my research was, given the beta wave society we are in, is it possible for us to bring our minds to a point where we are in alpha wave no matter what in a beta wave situation? Why? Because what that will allow us to do is it will allow our brain and body to be in a more sustainable state over a longer period of time in spite of what we have to do in the outside world. That is what is more important. No matter how much money we make, no matter whatever we do, if our mind is not able to be in a state independent of the situation around us, then it really does not matter. And in order to get to that point, can we do anything from our end? The beauty about India is we have a very old civilization which archaeologists from the Western world have been trying to deny for a long time, and now they have to accept that yes, as civilized nation, we've been existing for a long time. But with civilization comes medicine. And what we had was traditional medicine for an extremely long time. And therefore, our ancestors knew, even at that time, you had to address the brain. And so what I did, because all my colleagues in the US, they understand the mechanisms in the brain, but they don't necessarily, are not necessarily aware of the herbs and the bioactives available in our great nation of India. So I combined that knowledge which my family had and which I also had, along with the neuroscientific knowledge that I was educated in the US, and I tried to come up with these formulations that we can take on a day-to-day basis, because we say, right, oh, if we just have a stomach ache, we can take something. If we just have some small ache in the body, we can take something. But we do we treat the brain that way? No. Only if the guy is a psycho, we'll say, okay, take something. Or if he's depressed, really depressed, we take something. But depression isn't that far away from home as we think. It's a very day-to-day thing. So there is a way to maintain the brain on a day-to-day basis. And in order to do that, can we do it with natural ingredients? And so though I am educated in the US, though I was doing stuff in the US, my lab is in the US, I had to come here and I had to formulate stuff here because we have the ingredients that no other place has. And so we formulated certain things that can help with day-to-day maintenance of the brain. But more than that, like my fellow panelists, it's about education. It's about awareness that there is such a thing as a brain and there is such a thing as day-to-day maintenance of this brain and mind. In a nation where Westerners from all over the world who have all the money in the world, they come to this country to meditate, to understand about the mind. Well, we should be the same ones who provide those people with medicines or day-to-day maintenance things that can help maintain the stress and memory requirements and mental requirements that we need. So we are the yoga producers, but we should also be the mental health maintenance producers, and that is the goal. So that is mostly what I wanted to talk about. Yeah.
Thank you. That was very, very insightful. Just this question on why you mentioned there's an increase in suicide rates among Indians, and does that mean Indian children or in general?
So student suicide rates are unbelievable. They've increased more than any other demographic. Of course, farmer suicide is a very unfortunate thing, and that's part of the statistic. But student suicide is incredibly high.
Is it the highest in the world? I'm not
close to, yeah. It's close to the highest in the world.
So, what do you attribute it to? Just pressure of the education pressure, or what is it? Academics?
Yeah, definitely education pressure is there. I mean, there's a plus and a negative. Obviously, one thing we have to take into account is we are a very big nation. So whenever we have numbers that are high in any category, we have to take into account percentages. So percentages maybe not as bad, but it's still an important thing to take into account. But the point is, because parents always encourage their children to study well, that pressure is necessary, but that is part of it. But another thing is stress. Stress is something that is extremely high in today's society. And in the last 10 years, with smartphones and with internet and with everything, the ability for us to focus on studies. So we give them smartphones and we give everyone computers and TV and everything, and they can watch all of those things, but all of a sudden they're supposed to be able to study, you know, 300 pages in 7 hours. Where are they going to get the focus from? They train their mind to be able to go from one thing to the next, but all of a sudden they have to be focused. So it's very difficult to have the mind transition from this kind of lifestyle and still have the requirements that are required. And so it really affects their ability to do well in school because of the necessary pressure that is there. And then that results in
but
this.
But wouldn't that be a universal thing? Why Indians?
See, for example, like I said, of course, we have higher numbers when you compare to these Western places. But universally, the pressure that is there is not as much. There are many back doors in many other places where, okay, you get C grade in your 12th grade, you figure it out. I mean, you have options that you can do.
So we need to look at the way we are dealing with our kids and the pressures.
Yes, definitely.
And
but I also
yeah.
No, but even in work environments, for example, that same pressure is there, and there is truth to it. We are in a capitalistic world where we have to take our performance up to the higher level. It won't be serving our children well if we tell them, no, it's okay, you don't study. It is important that they study, but we also have to allow them to cope with that. We have to give them things that can allow them to meet those needs. So that's what I think, that's the solution. I don't think a solution is Three Idiots movie. Okay, that's very nice, but I don't think that is really sustainable, especially in our country.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks.
That was wonderful. And we will have a longer panel discussion later. Now we have Dr. Shyama Nagarajan from Whole Leaves Private Limited.
Thank you very much, Chair. And before I go into my deliberation, एक छोटा सा सवाल है. मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि मैं पेनल्टीमेट स्पीकर हूँ, क्योंकि बहुत सारे चीज़ें जो हमने बोलना था वो सब चीज़ चैलेंजेस क्यों हैं, कैसे हैं, ये सारी चीज़ें एड्रेस हो गई हैं. सो फॉर मी टू स्पीक इट बिकम्स सो मच सो ईजियर नाउ, बट इट्स अ डिफिकल्ट टास्क ऑल्सो टू जस्टिफाई माई स्टांस हियर. सो टू गिव यू अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन, I'm a pediatrician by training from All India Institute and did my master's in hospital administration and master's in public health. So this is an initiative that we as doctors, 15 of us together, joined and started this. I have my esteemed colleague and friend Dr. Amitabh Datta sitting on the audience, who is the founder of this initiative, of this program of ours, that why we should get into this. And we together felt, and Dr. Savitar, who is also an anesthetist, one of the branches in medicine, I don't know how many of you understand medicine well. Medicine mein jab aap branches ki baat karte hain, modern medicine ki baat kar rahi hu, modern medicine mein jab aap branches ki baat karte hain, hamara science bahut dissective science hai, theek hai. एक लीवर स्पेशलिस्ट है, एक किडनी स्पेशलिस्ट है, एक पीडियाट्रिशियन है. पीडियाट्रिशियन टू दैट एक्सटेंट इज मोर हॉलिस्टिक. मेडिसिन, इंटरनल मेडिसिन जो है वो थोड़ा मोर हॉलिस्टिक है. ऐसे ही एनेस्थेटिस्ट एक ऐसा स्पेशलिस्ट है हु अंडरस्टैंड्स द बॉडी फिजियोलॉजी मच बेटर देन मोस्ट ऑफ अस. रीजन बींग, दे हैव टू ट्रीट यू वेन यू आर इन एन अनकॉन्शियस स्टेट. दे हैव टू मेंटेन यू वेन यू कैन नॉट स्पीक. So therefore, they understand the pharmacology of medicines and your body dynamics much better. So therefore, you know, their insight was an insight of a playback singer in a movie, if you were to say. So that is what we brought to the table, to think through that what happens through our body in various systems, whether aap surgery kar rahe hain ya aap patient ko treat kar rahe hain, to kya hota hai. तो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ मैं आपको एक बोलती हूँ, जैसा फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू हैड एन इंजरी, तकलीफ होती है? होती है? लाउडली यार, बच्चे हैं सारे यहाँ पे. यस, किसी और को तकलीफ होती है, इंजरी होता है, तो आपको तकलीफ होता है? होता है? सेम लेवल ऑफ तकलीफ होता है? नहीं होता है? कभी सामने किसी बच्चे को गिरते हुए देखो और बताओ सेम लेवल ऑफ तकलीफ होती कि नहीं होती है. आपका बच्चा हो ना हो, किसी भी बच्चे को गिरते हुए देखोगे, किसी भी बच्चे को चोट लगते हुए देखोगे, अगर आप इंसान हो आपको तकलीफ होगी. कुत्ते को भी गिरते हुए देखोगे तो आपको तकलीफ होगी, होगी कि नहीं? सेम लेवल ऑफ पेन दैट यू गो थ्रू, राइट? दैट इज वॉट इज बींग ह्यूमन. दैट इज वॉट इज द ट्रिगर ऑफ स्टेइंग वेल. So wellness is that state of mind where despite being, whether aap tandrust hain ya aap diseased state mein hain ya aap theek ho gaye hain, un sab state mein bhi jab aap apne aap ko acha mehsoos kar rahe hain, jaisa one of my speaker Dr. Deepali said, it's all about being internal. Kya aap andar se jab apne aap ko tandrust mehsoos karte hain, well mehsoos karte hain, wahi wellness hai, वही ह्यूमननेस है. सो दैट इज़ वेयर वी थॉट दैट देर इज़ अ नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस इन अ ग्रेटर पर्सपेक्टिव. जैसा व्हाट इज दिस लीफ, कैन एनीबॉडी रिकग्नाइज क्या है ये? तुलसी में तीन पत्ते कभी नहीं होते. सी दिस इज द ट्रेजेडी. हाँ, हम इंडियंस हैं, हमारा कल्चर है, हमारा ट्रेडिशन है, हम अब नहीं पहचानते हैं इसको. अर्बन इंडिया नहीं पहचानता है. हम एक स्मॉल टाउन से हैं, मैं एक स्मॉल टाउन से हूँ, डॉक्टर दत्ता मेरे कलीग्स जो यहाँ बैठे हैं, हम सब स्मॉल टाउन से हम पेड़ पौधों के साथ बड़े हैं, हम रिकग्नाइज करते हैं। आज मुझे अपनी बेटी को घर में तुलसी लगाना पड़ता है दिखाने के लिए कि तुलसी ऐसे दिखती है। कितने तरह के तुलसी हैं हिंदुस्तान के अंदर ही, 21 तरह के तुलसी हैं हिंदुस्तान अकेले में, 21 तरह के तुलसी हैं। हम नहीं जानते, नहीं जानना कोई गलत बात नहीं है, राइट? बट ये क्या है? कितने यहाँ शिव भक्त हैं भाई? आधे हाथ दिखते नहीं है मुझे, चश्मा पहना हुआ है। चढ़ाते हो बेल का पत्ता? शिव जी को बेल पत्ता चढ़ाते हैं? ये बेल पत्ता है, राइट? नाउ बेल पत्ता का जो थ्री लीव्स है, दे हैव गॉट अ सिग्निफिकेंस इन आर लाइफ, दे हैव अ सिग्निफिकेंस इन आर कल्चर। संस्कृति में इसका बहुत सिग्निफिकेंस है कि हम हर चीज़ को एक ट्राइपॉड की तरह सोचते हैं। हमने भी अपने इनिशिएटिव को, जब हमने सोचा कि एज डॉक्टर्स हम क्या करते हैं, हम जब पेशेंट को ट्रीट करते हैं, पेशेंट हमारा ठीक होके चला जाता है, जैसे दीपाली ने भी बताया, पेशेंट ठीक होके चला गया, पर किसी भी पेशेंट को अगर आप देखो, आप 100% वापस नहीं दे सकते हो जो उसके पास कुदरती तौर पे था, करेक्ट? जिस चीज़ से आप पैदा हुए थे, जो ईश्वर ने आपको जैसे बनाया, उतना 100% तो आप कुछ भी करके वापस नहीं दे सकते। इट पेन्स यू, इट पेन्स ऑल ऑफ अस टू सी दैट वी एज डॉक्टर्स वी हैव डन सच अ ग्रेट वर्क। खुद को बहुत खुदा महसूस कर लिए, खुश हो गए, पेशेंट भी थैंक यू बोल के चला गया, डॉक्टर साहब आप महान हो, सब बोल के चला गया, उसके बाद भी आपको तकलीफ होता है। हमने बहुत कुछ जो करना चाहिए था हम नहीं कर पा रहे। क्यों नहीं कर पा रहे? बिकॉज जो डैमेज हो गया है वो हो चुका है, उसको हम ठीक नहीं कर सकते। सो आर थॉट वॉज, हाउ डू वी एनकरेज पीपल टू फॉल आउट ऑफ द ट्रैप ऑफ गेटिंग डिजीज्ड? हाउ शुड दे बिकम वेल? हाउ शुड दे स्टार्ट थिंकिंग अबाउट देयर ओन वेलनेस? दैट वॉज द आइडिया। एंड हमने सोचा हम कर क्या सकते हैं, राइट? वी आर इन द एंटायर कॉस्मस, इन द एंटायर यूनिवर्स, वी आर स्मॉल बीइंग्स इन दैट एंटायर यूनिवर्स। इफ यू सी इन आर गैलेक्सी, राइट, इन आर गैलेक्सी आर यूनिवर्स इज अ स्मॉल पीस। इन दैट यूनिवर्स ऑफ आर्स अर्थ इज वन स्मॉल थिंग। इन दिस होल अर्थ, इन दिस होल वर्ल्ड, इंडिया इज वन बिग कंट्री। इन दैट वन बिग कंट्री विथ सो मच मोर पॉपुलेशन, आई एम वन स्मॉल बींग, राइट? कैन आई मेक अ चेंज? इट लुक्स अ बिग टास्क, बट आई कैन डेफिनेटली मेक अ बिगिनिंग। यही हमारी संस्कृति भी हमें बोलती है, आपको कुछ चेंज करने की जरूरत नहीं है, जो आपके बस में है आप यहाँ कर सकते हो उतना आप करिए। दैट इज वॉट वी डिड, दैट वी आइडेंटिफाइड वॉट इज दैट इज लैकिंग। सो लेट मी टेक यू थ्रू द चैलेंजेस वॉट वी फेस्ड। तीन चीज हैं अगर आप किसी भी चीज़ को देखो, एक है नॉलेज, कंज्यूमर यानी आप और हम सब हैं इसमें, और जो हमारा मार्केट डायनामिक्स है। आज का प्रेजेंट डे मार्केट में बहुत सारे प्रोडक्ट्स अवेलेबल हैं, सब तरह की चीज़ें आपके पास अवेलेबल हैं। आप पूछते हो ये ऑर्गेनिक है, ये हर्बल है, ठीक है, देर आर नो प्रिजर्वेटिव्स इन इट, विल इट हार्म मी, विल इट कॉज एनी एलर्जीज, राइट? ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस आर देयर इन आर माइंड, ठीक है। देर आर प्रोडक्ट्स वी ट्रस्ट, कुछ कंपनीज के प्रोडक्ट हम ट्रस्ट करते हैं, क्यों? क्योंकि हमें ट्रांसपेरेंटली बताया जाता है कि ये चीज़ ये है, ये आप ट्रांसपेरेंटली देखिए, ये समझिए, सो वी आर एबल टू ट्रस्ट। बट वॉट अबाउट द लार्जर ग्रुप विच वी आर नॉट एबल टू ट्रस्ट, विच आर नॉट एज ऑब्वियस? सो वॉट इज एन ऑप्शन फॉर मी? द फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज वॉट वी कॉल एज ऑथिक्स चैलेंज। वी कॉइंड दिस वर्ड बिकॉज देर आर टू इश्यूज इन टू इट। वन इज ऑथेंटिसिटी, फ्रॉम वेयर इट केम, वॉट इट केम, एंड द एथिकल डायमेंशन, कि किसके लिए क्या ज़रूरी है। ये बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है। ज़रूरी नहीं है कि मेरे पास कुछ है तो वो आपके लिए फिट है। जैसा डॉक्टर ईशा ने बोला, मैंने एक खाना खाया, ज़रूरी नहीं है वो मेरे लिए फिट है, किसी और के लिए कोई और चीज़ फिट है। सो इट इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टू एथिकली बी आउट ऑफ एनी काइंड ऑफ कन्फ्लिक्ट। आप जब किसी को एडवाइस कर रहे हैं, आपको अपने आप को उससे बाहर निकाल के उस बंदे के तरफ से सोचना पड़ेगा कि उसके लिए क्या उचित है। to mix these two, it is a great challenge in the market today. Right? Market mein ye sabse bada problem hai, unregulated market hai, ye sabse bada problem hai. Dusra problem kya hai? Dusra problem aap aur hum khud hai. Kyun? Kyunki sabse bada cheez hai, the disease of abundance. Jo Harish ji ne bola, the disease of abundance. Aaj ka middle class community, elite community, bahut kuch hai. I call this disease of abundance as starvation. In medical language, we call it as starvation. Why do we call it starvation? Because we hoard food. Hum sab kuch apne liye leke sanjote hain. Janwar jo hain, jitna zarurat hai, utna khata hai aur chalte banta hai. So life chain mein, sher ne khaya, uske baad baki janwar khate hain, aur sabse jyada last mein aata hai, aapka suwar, makhi wagaira sab aake khate hain. To ek janwar ke marne pe, ek janwar ko maar ke, kam se kam 20 alag tarike ke janwar different level pe khana khake chale jate hain, usi janwar pe. Right? Jungle mein yehi hota hai. But hum insaan kya karte hain? Especially when you have lot of money, you hoard things. So ye hoarding jo hai, that itself is a challenge. That itself is a cause of starvation. You yourself starve. Theek hai? And then the other situation is, we ask about insurance. Thank God I have insurance. Boss, why should you be so happy ki tumhare paas insurance hai? You should be unhappy that you are in a surgical table, you are on an OT table, anything can happen. Death is the ultimate that can happen, right? Any drug that can happen. Why are you so happy that you have an insurance? Now what is the other challenge? The other challenge is awareness challenge. Aaj ke date mein Google bhai ke paas sare jawab hain. Ye ek aisa desh hai jahan pe research ko bahut badhawa diya gaya hai shuru se. Humne Ramayan 15 logon ne 15 different tarike se likh diye. Mahabharat ko 15 logon ne 15 different tarike se likh diye. Scientific research is bhumi mein jitna zyada hota tha pehle aaj nahi hota hai. Aaj ka modern Indian jo hai research karne se katrata hai. Kyun? Research karne mein samay lagta hai, time dena padta hai. Bahut sare research fail hote hain tab aap samajhte ho kuch ek baat ko. Correct? Aaj hum kya hai, information seeker hain. Google bhai bata deta hai, WhatsApp bata deta hai, hum sab ek dusre ko bhejte rehte hain. Information is not knowledge. Please understand that difference. That information has to be analyzed with similar like-minded people. I think your mic...
You just need to be a little closer. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So what is that we can do? So we thought, ye challenge hai, hum kya kar sakte hain? ठीक है, पहला चैलेंज है मार्केट सिचुएशन को क्या मैं बदल सकती हूँ? नो, ये रेगुलेटर का काम है. मार्केट डीरेगुलेटर है, मैं एज एन इंडिविजुअल उसको कुछ नहीं कर सकती, सरकार उस पर कर सकती है. फेयर इनफ. सेकेंड इज, कैन वी चेंज द बिहेवियर ऑफ पीपल? यू एंड मी, आई विल फिनिश. कैन वी चेंज द बिहेवियर ऑफ पीपल टू सम एक्सटेंट? नॉट आज जैसे उन्होंने कहा 20-25 लोगों में से अगर एक भी सुधर जाए तो दैट्स अ वर्क डन. कैन वी चेंज सम टू सम एक्सटेंट? कैन वी कंट्रोल द सोर्स फ्रॉम वेयर वी ब्रिंग थिंग्स? कहाँ से हम क्या लाते हैं, कैन वी कंट्रोल है? या वी कैन. कैन आई क्रिएट नॉलेज? यस. एज डॉक्टर्स, अंडरस्टैंडिंग मेडिसिन, अंडरस्टैंडिंग वॉट हैपन्स रॉन्ग विद माई बॉडी, आई थिंक आई कैन डेफिनेटली डू दिस वर्क. So what we therefore thought is, our initiative should be to create a complete knowledge base, to create a knowledge, a set of knowledge, so that we can give authentic information to people that where you should look for wellness, how we can use the plant medicine in and around us. Hamare paas bahut sampada hai jo aaj ke date mein टन्स पे ही बाहर चला जाता है और आपके पास वापस कॉस्मेटिक और फूड प्रोडक्ट्स बन के आते हैं. जैसा होल फूड की कॉन्सेप्ट बोल रही हैं, होल चीज़ों को लेने में हमें तकलीफ होता है. जीरा आप पाउडर लेके आते हो, जीरा साबत लाके पीसने में आज के डेट में हमारे को तकलीफ होती है. क्यों होती है? इट डज टेक्स अ मिनट टू डू दैट, राइट? बट वी सीक फॉर कन्वीनियंस, वी सीक फॉर ईज ऑफ डूइंग थिंग्स.
So therefore, we therefore thought,
ma'am, can we have your concluding remarks?
Yeah.
So what we ended up doing was to go back to the basics. Go back to the basics of much more holistic a medicine. जो हमारा साइंटिफिक ट्रेडिशन है वो बहुत होलिस्टिक है, ट्रेडिशनली हम करते हैं. अगर आप देखें, दिस इज़ अ पिक्चर ऑफ अ लीफ हियर, राइट? पत्ते जो होते हैं, पत्ते के नीचे अगर आप देखें, जो छोटी छोटी पत्तियां हैं, छोटे से यहाँ पे, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज स्टिप्यूल्स. दे प्रिजर्व द लीफ, दे प्रिजर्व द लीफ टिल दे बिकम मैच्योर. दैट इज द वे इट एक्चुअली कंटेन्स द एक्टिव इन्ग्रेडियंट. जो हम आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस की आज बात करते हैं, द प्लांट्स ऑलरेडी हैड इट इन देम. इट इज नॉट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, इट इज एक्टिव इंग्रेडिएंट. सो व्हाट वी हैव डन इज आइडेंटिफाइड दोज लोकल थिंग्स इन एंड अराउंड अस, ब्रॉट देम फ्रॉम द वेरी सोर्सेज दैट दे ग्रो, देयर नेचुरल एनवायरमेंट. हम ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं, हम कुछ नहीं कर रहे हैं. उनके नेचुरल हैबिटेट में वो जहाँ ग्रो कर सकते हैं नेचुरली, वहाँ से to bring out with a well-researched documentation to all of us, telling them how you can use this leaf in your day-to-day life, how you can enhance your wellness, how you can use them, how you should not be using, when you should not be using. क्या आपको पता है तुलसी को आपको दांतों तले नहीं दबाना चाहिए? ये पता है किसी को? क्यों? Yeah, why does it spoil your teeth? It degrades calcium, it degrades dentin. उसको हर समय अपने तालू पे रख के खाना चाहिए, right? इसीलिए powder कर दिया जाता है तुलसी को, या पीस दिया जाता है. प्रसाद में आपको सिर्फ इतना देता है, कोई आपको तुलसी इतना उठा के नहीं देता है, right? These are some of the traditional knowledge important that we as modern medicine doctors have assimilated and brought it to the table through our Whole Leaves initiative, that we want to connect the people to the entire boundaries of your nature so that we can foster wellness. That is the entire motto, that along with the knowledge we come back and talk about wellness to people, so that you don't come to us. We don't want you to come to us. That's our intent, that jis din hamari zarurat kam pad rahi hai, उसका मतलब हमारा काम बहुत अच्छे से हो गया.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू सो मच मैम. वी नीड मेनी मेनी मोर पीपल लाइक यू टू मेक दैट डिफरेंस. एंड आई थिंक व्हाट यू आर डूइंग इज एब्सोल्युटली ब्रिलियंट.
थैंक यू.
मच नीडेड. एंड विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट.
थैंक यू.
जस्ट वन कमेंट दैट यू मेंशनड से तुलसी. देयर आर थाउजेंड्स एंड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ हर्ब्स व्हिच आर अवेलेबल. We talk about Brahmi, and so there is an issue with people who are taking medication. For instance, if I'm taking Ecosprin, am I to take blood? So Brahmi or Ginkgo or whatever it is. So how do you take? How would you take care of that?
Okay, so that is where I said that we are a group of doctors here. I don't know whether you heard Dr. Nandini Devan. She was an ex-DG ICMR. So we have a complete research team. Dr. Savitar is here, he's one of the researchers. He's also an anesthetist from background. And we have got around 15 odd doctors who do this research completely. Before saying that, say for example, we do not encourage women or young men to take bale in a large quantity, because they cause bale, while it has got its importance, it can cause infertility. So young adults should not be taking bale.
So would you be putting these warnings?
Oh yes, we do all of those information whenever somebody, that's the entire initiative all about, that when you sell or when you bring about a particular product into the market, you give it with the knowledge ki iska ye use hai, isko aap aise use kijiye, iske sath ye nahi khana chahiye, aapko kitna regularly use karna chahiye, and we are giving that in a whole form. We are not giving it in a powdered form, because powder hote hi mere ko nahi malum ki wo powder mein ghaas hai ya kya hai. This is to ensure the authenticity ki aap patte ko dekhiye, samjhiye, janiye.
हर चीज को प्लांट है प्लांट पार्ट से उसको होल एज फार एज पॉसिबल देखिए एंड इट विल टॉक टू यू स्लोली इन सिक्स मंथ्स टाइम आई कैन टेल यू इट विल स्टार्ट टॉकिंग टू यू एज यू सेड ब्राह्मी सेम इज द केस विद थाइम थाइम अगर आप प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन को दे रही हैं तो वो ब्लीडिंग डिसऑर्डर अगर वो प्री प्रेगनेंसी में ले रही है पोटेंशियल ऑफ प्लेसेंटल डिस्ट्रप्शन इज देयर सो वी गिव ऑल दोज नॉलेज इन अ लीफलेट अलॉन्ग विथ वॉट एवर वी आर टॉकिंग इट्स ऑल देयर ऑन अवर वेबसाइट ऑल्सो
एंड सो ब्राह्मी कैन बी यूज बाय अ चाइल्ड हू स्टडिंग फॉर एग्जाम्स
इट कैन बी यूज बट इट हैज टू बी यूज इन अ स्पेसिफिक क्वांटिटी वी मेजर दैट क्वांटिटी एंड टेल यू That entire research, that is why we have a group of doctors doing that research. Excellent. And we mix both Ayush medicine and modern medicine, but we are only talking, we are not doing Ayurveda as a treatment here. We are only looking at so much which is required for wellness. And when you talk about wellness, aap ek hi din mein, jaise aap jaanti hain, ki ek hi din mein agar B-complex sara 20 ka 20 mein kha loon, toh mere ko koi fayda nahi hone wala. It will all get excreted through urine. What we say is, थोड़ा थोड़ा क्वांटिटी ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम सिक्स मंथ्स इट विल एक्चुअली एनहांस
वंडरफुल थैंक यू सो मच मैम
थैंक यू
एंड नाउ वी हैव मच अवेटेड प्रीति प्रीति राव शी इज अ वेलनेस गुरु प्लीज
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन एंड इट्स माय एब्सोल्यूट प्लेजर टू बी हियर विद यू टुडे थैंक यू इशी जी टू बी द मॉडरेटर फॉर दिस सेशन एंड टू ब्रिंग your valuable knowledge and thank you my dear panelist for sharing all the information that you've shared and I've left with the most challenging task of concluding this session and talk about the behavioral science that's behind wellness can I get the cursor before I move on, I wanted to tell you a little bit more about my personal journey and why Weljii came into being. I'm a passionate person. I've always been passionate about health and wellness ever since I was 16. At the age of 16, I was the former Reebok fitness brand ambassador, and my life actually began from the very physical realm of things, beauty and fitness. Very soon, as I was 22 years old, I went to the Shivananda Ashram where I learned yoga and really landed up in the realm of spirituality. And I really started pondering on, is wellness only physical? And really, wellness is multifaceted. We cannot really look at wellness just from how many calories we've consumed and how many steps we've taken. Every individual here is far more complex. Every individual here is unique and comes from a unique life experience. So Weljii, well, from the very onset, means life of wellness. And our focus is changing people's lifestyle. Changing people's lifestyle in a manner that is sustainable, that is anchored on the science of behavioral change, the neuroscience of behavioral change. So as I mentioned, very early on, I was exploring questions when I was at the Shivananda Ashram. Who am I? What makes me happy? What's my calling in life? And I think it has done great service to me that I was asking those profound questions at that time. And the answer that came back to me was dedicating my life towards health and wellness. And that's why Weljii came into being. I've had the experience of working internationally in America with many great organizations, Aetna, which is largest insurance company in the world, Charlotte Maxwell Center for Cancer, UCSF Center for Integrative Medicine. You know, on my return to India, I've also worked with Max Hospitals. What I've noticed is disease is far more complex. Individuals are far more complex. So our vision is to facilitate an improved quality of life, health and well-being by sustainable lifestyle behavioral changes. This sounds really complex, and I'm going to break it down into simpler words. A little bit more about Weljii. We're also the recipient of the 50 Best Wellness Company Award for Innovation in Healthcare. And this is the reason why I came back from America, because the non-communicable disease epidemic in India is appalling. We are the world's largest diabetes capital, and also 60% of all deaths going forward from heart disease is going to come to India, come from India. We're living a highly sedentary lifestyle as well. I hold some prestigious nominations. I'm also the National Wellness Institute committee member involved in spreading wellness globally. I'm also the mentor coach by International Consortium of Health and Wellness Coaches, where my job is to mentor others in the profession of health and wellness. So let me ask you guys a question. What do you think determines your health? Any answers? What really determines your health? Is it your genes? Is it environment? Any other answers? Yes, please. Right. So thank you so much for sharing that. So what determines our health is there are many different things, like you mentioned, and all of them are intertwined and integrated with each other. Medical care, if you look at research that's been done on this space, says that 10% comes from medical care, 16% from our genetic composition, our hereditary, that comes from our lineage, from our parents, our grandparents, our environment, the environment that we live in, but most importantly, appallingly, it's our lifestyle. When we talk about lifestyle, we're not only talking about nutrition, but we're talking about mental well-being, emotional well-being, relational well-being, spiritual well-being, our ability to have a great mindset towards stress, our ability to have a great quality of life, our ability to have great relationships in our life. So our lifestyle really affects our health. So this brings me to the neuroscience of behavioral change. And we talk about, when we talk about lifestyle and behavioral sciences, it's very easy to say, tell someone, you know, you need to exercise, you know, you need to eat healthy food. But it's far more difficult to implement that in your life. Telling people what to do does not really work. People only make changes when they're inspired to make changes. People only make changes when they're motivated. No matter how much you tell somebody to do whatever they want, they should be doing, they'll do it only when they want to do it. And therein comes the science of neuroscience, of behavioral change. Let me tell you a little more. Our brain is made of billions and millions of neurons. We know that, right? These neurons are communicating with each other. These neurons are connected with something called dendrites, right? The connection between neurons and dendrites allows the communication between these neurons. Now, every time we have a new behavior, these dendrites are formed, right? The number of times we continue to doing the same behavior, the same habit, for example, eating healthier foods, we keep doing that, these connections become stronger. And research says that the same habit has to be repeated 10,000 times before it kind of formulates towards being a sustainable lifestyle habit. Therefore, it takes about an average 3 months, 90 days for somebody to make a small lifestyle change. And it takes about a year for that habit to become a sustainable habit. This is an interesting example. If you look at your own life, you have particular habits, right? You'll wake up at a particular time, you eat a particular way, you live a particular way, you manage your relationship in a particular way. There's a way you think and you operate. If you look at a conventional approach, if you look at the diagram on the left-hand side, where we have Mr. Simpson's here, what really happens? Usually, for our behavior, there is a trigger, right? Trigger is, maybe I've had a long day at work, I want to sit on my couch, and I'm craving for a glass of beer. Or this is my time that I open a packet of chips and I want to eat it. This is a pattern that I do over and over, over and over. There are patterns, if you look at your life, that you formulated in the last 5, 10, 15, 20 years. Am I right? Right? Everything around you has been cultivated ever since you were a little baby. Now I have this trigger. I've come back from work and I'm really tired. I'm sitting on the couch and I have this trigger that this is my time to snack. Okay? Now, this is my routine. Now, when I pick up that snack and actually eat a chip, It's a reward for me, right? Now that I've eaten this one chip, it leads to more craving because I'm not going to be satisfied with one chip. Have you ever had one chip or one cookie? Very difficult, right? Now, when you've had the second chip, you'll probably land up having the entire packet of chips, right? At least half of it, maybe 15, maybe 20. So this sends a message in my brain that I'm hungry, and the cycle keeps continuing, right? Now, if I were to change my behavior, if I have heightened levels of awareness around my own activities, or have a deeper level of connection with myself. Now, unlike the other example that I gave, you come back home, you sit on the couch, you think about this packet of chips, but you tell your brain, because you're aware and you want to make a change, you said, you know what, I'm going to replace that with something healthy. You go out and reach out for something that's more healthy, more complex. You pick up a healthier food product. You're still being rewarded, but you've now shifted the communication in your brain. It's shifting. It was used to doing A, is now doing B, right? Now, when you're still getting rewarded, because now you feel you've eaten something that's healthy, you feel accomplished, you now want to eat more, you eat that more, and this routine needs to keep continuing. When this pattern keeps continuing over and over and over and over and over and over, over 10,000 times, over the next 90 days, over the next 1 year, you formulated a lifestyle. And this is the key. That is why behavioral science is very important. 70 to 80% of all lifestyle diseases today are stemming out of poor lifestyles. Poor people are becoming marginally more poor because they're not educated on lifestyle. They're under debt. They cannot afford hospital care. The rich are becoming highly stressed, malnourished, in spite of abundance of food, like most our panelists have been talking about. But change, making a change, is it really easy? If I tell you to now shift that pattern that you saw Mr. Simpson do that momentarily in the last slide, how easy is it for me to change my habit? Is it easy? Yes? No? It's difficult, right? So how can we think that if we tell somebody what to do, they're going to change right away? Therefore, Prochaska's transtheoretical model of change says that at least about 5 steps to change. The first step is pre-contemplation. Most of the time, these are people who think they don't need to change. Have you seen people around your life, your spouses, your boyfriends, your girlfriends, your father, your mother, you keep telling them, aap ye kyun nahi karte ho? Aap exercise kyun nahi karte ho? Aap achha khate kyun nahi ho? Aap stress kyun lete ho? Aap smoking kyun nahi chhod dete ho? But they've been used to doing that. They're likely pre-contemplators because they think the problem is not with me. I don't need to change. These people usually take about 6 to 1 year before they start making any kind of change. The next stage is called contemplation. That means I'm contemplating. Maybe I can think about this, right? Now, the chances of these people actually making a change is a little more than pre-contemplation. These people, likely within the next 3 to 6 months, are likely to start making some sort of a lifestyle change. The next stage is preparation, right? These people say, okay, I know I have to make a change. I think this is the need of the hour. Now, how do I really go about it? They're starting to think. They're starting to plan. Have you ever thought about starting to go and start a workout? Do you do planning? Right? So these people are people who start planning and then they get into the action phase. They actually get to the gym. They actually start changing their lifestyle. They start looking at their relationships. They start looking, exploring happiness and every aspect of their life. And they start getting into the action phase and they keep doing it in a routine over and over and over again. At some point, they're going to reach a stage of maintenance. Just because they have accomplished this 1 year of sustainable change does not mean they're going to be okay. People can quit smoking for a year and still relapse, right? So it's very important, the maintenance phase. So it's very important as we coach people for lifestyle diseases that we're able to map them across these stages. so far, in the last few decades, when we've looked at nutrition, we've been looking at nutrition mostly from weight. आप जब भी किसी को मिलते हैं सबसे पहला चीज क्या नोटिस करते हैं वो आप में? आप मोटे हो गए हो, आप तो पतले हो गए हो, करेक्ट? होता है, ठीक है ना? So most important thing, one of the first thing we notice is how is that person looking in terms of appearance, right? Has he lost or gained weight? And our approach has also been weight centric. And I think time has changed. We need to change our approach. Instead of focusing so much about weight, we need to be focused on health and well-being. Weight, when we constantly think about weight and calories, we're thinking about I need to diet, I need to deprive myself. And life is not about deprivation. Life is about enjoying the abundance that is around you in moderation, right? So when we look at a weight-centric or a typical biomedical model, we are looking at an individual from a unidimensional way. We're only looking at the physical dimension, right? In our society right now, we have too many specialists, cardiologists, oncologists. You know, we have too many specialists. What the need of the hour is, we need more generalists, people who can coach people on day-to-day lifestyle habit change. The conventional approach is to prescribe and treat, right? We usually give a prescription. Say somebody's just had a heart attack, right? They go through a surgery and the doctor tells them you need to change your lifestyle, right? They tell you to start eating better, start walking. But just telling them and prescribing them, it's very, very hard for them to actually go ahead and implementing that. On the contrary, when we look at the health-centered approach is a more integrative approach. When we're talking about nutrition, we're not just looking at carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, but we're looking at nutrition from an integrative mindset. We're looking at the mind, body, spirit. What is my mindset towards food? What is my relationship with food? What does food really mean for me? Does food give me joy? Do I eat when I'm stressed? Do I eat when I'm happy? Am I living an isolated life? Do I have a larger vision, purpose in life? I've coached a lot of people. In fact, one of the recent women I coached, the reason she said in the coaching session that she was overweight and she was struggling with this for so many years is because she said something so profound. She said, you know, I am today not the woman I wanted to be. My image of the woman that I wanted to be is very different than the life that I'm living. That was an awakening moment. She realized her relationship with food was a source of an ally for her. She was depending on food to fill this void, right? So people use food for many different reasons. So we cannot just look at it as simply at carbs, fats, and proteins. What's also interesting is that the prescribe and treat model needs to replace with motivating and co-creating the plan with the client. When I mean co-creating, I mean that the client is in charge and is in charge of their life. Our job as wellness coaches is to train the client, to empower the client to become the best versions of themselves. How do we motivate them? How do we educate them? How do we help them to find their own resources? How do we help them to overcome their own obstacles and really create a life vision towards healthy lifestyle? Research says 95% of all everybody who diets fails. How many people have you seen around yourself? They will lose weight, gain weight, lose weight, yes? Right? And dieting, this kind of industry has led to a bias towards revenue generation. There are a lot of quick fixes in the market, lose 5 kgs in a month. Have you seen those text messages coming on 5 kgs in a month, 10 inches, 2 inches in a month? Really, that's not realistic. It has to be highly personalized. So what's really needed, I'll have two more slides. What's really needed is authentic selling, right? And what's even more powerful is having presence of mind and being mindful of what you're eating and really enjoying, relishing your food. This is my second last slide. So what is the new healthcare pyramid? What is it going to really look like? let's look at this pyramid. When you look at the top of the pyramid, it says 5% of all our healthcare crisis as it relates to non-communicable diseases, whether it is diabetes, cancer, hypertension, will be addressed at the hospital where people need acute care and hospitalization, right? The next 25% of people are those people who are fairly kind of have these issues but don't need hospitalization but need specialized care. The bottom of the pyramid is where the maximum number of our population exists, right? This is 70 to 80% of our population. People like you and I, we have life challenges. We want to make changes so that we don't become sick or have an early onset of disease. Now, this 70% of people can be addressed by a trained health and wellness coach. Who is a health and wellness coach? Now, a health and wellness coach is somebody who's trained on the science of behavioral change, on the neuroscience of behavioral change. This is somebody who understands coaching psychology. This is somebody who understands cognitive behavior. This is somebody who understands other learning theories. This is somebody who understands what is motivation. How do we really help people from making changes in a scientific evidence manner? These are people who are trained on the science of nutrition, exercise, stress, from a holistic perspective when we're looking at food, relationship, mind, body, play, spirituality. Therefore, this, my dear friends, is really the key to a healthy lifestyle. So a health and wellness coach navigates people from a sick care mechanism to wellness. So when I say that, when somebody is falling sick, the first thing that they see is signs of illness. The second thing that they see is symptoms. And then they see some sort of a disability. Then there's early onset of death, right? When we move people from the illness to the wellness continuum, what coaches are really doing is creating a deeper level of awareness. If you're overweight, why are you overweight? Right? What is your relationship with food? What is the root cause of why you have diabetes or hypertension? When we have this heightened level of awareness, we educate the client, we facilitate a mindset growth, a growth mindset, right? When a person is in a growth mindset, they see an opportunity to change and they're coached and they're handheld in the process of change. This leads, my dear friend, this leads to a higher level of awareness. This was actually created by somebody called John Travis, who's a leading author and a wellness specialist. So I hope I've made my point. Behavior is complex, but it's not that we cannot change our behavior. We just need assistance. We need wellness coaches, and wellness coaches packed with power of behavioral change can really make a huge impact in controlling and management of lifestyle diseases and helping people to lead an improved quality of life and overall wellness. Here is where you can reach me. Thank you so much for listening to me patiently with all this noise in the background. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Preeti.
So farmers are giving us a tough time in the other hall. I think there's some argument with the speakers. So they are getting out of control. We've called the security. So I think we will calm it down.
Yeah.
Sure.
Well, that's heated for sure. Okay. So should we conclude our session now? So basically,
they wanted a few questions were there in the audience. So we can quickly wrap it up with two or three questions.
All right, so if you have few questions, we can quickly take them up.
Hi, good morning.
Hi.
So my question to you is that what if you have a terminal disease? How does wellness structure then? How do you address wellness? Because wellness is supposed to be all three, mind, body and soul. But if your body is collaborating, what do you do then?
Yeah, so in fact, you've just taken something which I have concluded on, to say that the body has an amazing inherent capacity to heal. Never underestimate the body's healing capacity. It just needs the right opportunity and the right setting. I'm very tempted to share a story with you since you talked about terminal illness. There is a gentleman by the name Amit Vaidya.
He developed cancer at the age of 38, lived in the US, US citizen, born, brought up there. He lost his mother to cancer, father to heart disease, and then within the next 3 years, it was his turn. His father was a pharmacist, and he therefore believed in mainstream treatment and went ahead with chemotherapies after he was diagnosed with stage 2 cancer of the stomach. Rounds of chemotherapy didn't help. He became sicker, and he reached stage 4, literally dying. He was alone at home and decided to come back to India to die. And here he lived with the family, some relatives in a farm in Chhatarpur, and started yoga because the family was doing yoga. He did kunjal, he did some yoga exercises, and began to feel slightly better. From a stage where he had given up on himself, from a stage where he had actually no path to take, he decided that he would want to pursue yoga more seriously. He did exactly what he was told in the yoga class and was well enough to then travel to a farm in Gujarat, which he had heard about. That farm was about cows, about the desi cow, along with the products, the panchgarbhya of the cow, from the cow urine to the cow dung to the ghee, etc., etc. He was kept on jwar ki rotis and fresh vegetables which were grown organically around the farm. And from feeling slightly better, he began to improve significantly. He had lesions on his back which began to heal, and he suddenly began to see the light at the end of the tunnel. Within a year, he was in touch with his doctors in the US. Within a year, he was declared cancer-free. And after that, he changed the mission of his life. He was a journalist, and now he has not gone back to the US. It's been, I think, 6 or 8 years since this has happened. He's written a book, The Cow That Saved My Life. Holy Cancer, The Cow That Saved My Life. I urge you all to pick it up. And he has a foundation, and he's made this mission to spread the word around. It's called the Healing Vaidya Foundation. I think that answers your question.
Hi, thank you so much, Ishi. This was, I think, most needed. And I would just like to follow it up with a question to Dr. Shyama about the herbs and the power of herbs that you have briefly touched upon. I want to get to know more about the research which links the power of these herbs to terminal illnesses and to various other diseases which can be cured not only within India but on a global level. So if you can highlight some of the aspects of the research and how it can be applied across a global platform.
As I said, we have identified around 88 plant and plant parts, of which we have researched in detail about 11 of them, which we have landed up for the common use. We are not going into Ayush as a medicine per se, because that's not our forte. Our forte is primarily because the best thing about modern medicine is it's able to dissect things further. So it creates an evidence pool very well. So the evidence generation is what we are doing through the existing literature, and we are connecting with various traditional medicine experts, botanists. They are all there as our panelists, whom we draw upon to develop research products. And we are not doing any productization in the sense like it's not a preserved product that we don't create. What we say is that we will foster wellness to prevent you from a particular disease or getting diseased at all. So what we are saying is, as she pointed out, it is the behavioral change that we are pushing towards. That, say for example, look at rosemary. Rosemary is very good for Alzheimer's. It grows in the southern and western parts of the country. It's very good for mental capacity building to enhance focus. It's also good for Alzheimer's. So what we say is that along with the day-to-day ghee and food that you take, start taking rosemary as a part of your tea, as an infusion. Don't take tea separately. Take that, you would not have Alzheimer's or disease like Parkinson's going forward. So if one can actually go back and see, why do you see so many cancer today? I can argue saying that in the yesteryears, probably we were not able to identify or diagnose cancer and heart disease. I can also counter argue and say that probably they ate well and drank well, therefore they never fell sick, right? So what we want to do is that to encourage people to go into that side of wellness rather than, you know, trying to get themselves treated. For that, we have got a lot of doctors, medicine, the integrated medicine of ours. It is a very rich science. The only thing with Ayush, what we have not done is bringing the documenting all the evidences that we are trying to do will take some time. We have started the journey. We as modern medicine doctors trying to put those things together. And if there are people who want to come along with us and share their information with us, we'll be very happy to do that because that's the intent.
Thank you so much.
Have I answered your question?
Yes, please.
Thank you.
One last question. That gentleman told me long back that he has a question to ask. So after this, we'll wrap up because speakers for other session are already waiting outside and we have to start.
The question is for Dr. Damodaran. So Dr. Damodaran, you mentioned some time back that, you know, you have come back to India because these are a problem that you are able to see. Now, unfortunately for me, I could not understand the solution that you are bringing about for this.
Sure. The solution, firstly, come back to India in the sense that when we're talking about how do you deal with the mental pressures that we have, both for students and for, you know, 30-year-olds or 40-year-olds with stress, the solution that we're talking about is can we use herbs and take the bioactives from there and combine it in ways that can address specific mechanisms for our brain and help us cope with the problems. So my research had to do first with understanding what is happening to the brain from a mechanistic standpoint that makes it act in these kind of ways, that doesn't allow us to be calm in a stressful situation. Now the idea was, okay, you understand the mechanisms, now what can we do to solve it? So the in answer to your question, the NeuroClub booth for which I have come here and what I was talking about was this effort that we've given to make these products, these capsules or whatever, using science and using these bioactives available in Indian herbs to address these different issues, specific brain issues that are actually day-to-day issues. It's not normal people can take it because they have this requirement. So that is why I came back here to combine these herbs to make these things.
These are the supplements that we are talking about?
Yes.
Thank you, speakers, and my dear audience, for being so patient, and to the speakers for such a lovely, enriching session on healthy living. Now I will request Ms. Isha Khosla to please hand over token of appreciation to all our distinguished speakers. To start with, Mr. Harish Chand. Can we have a round of applause for all our speakers? Ms. Preeti Rao. Dr. Shyama Nagarajan. Dr. Sriraman Damodaran. And now I would request Aarti from AI Group to hand over the memento to Ms. Khosla. Thank you, ma'am.